Hello and welcome to the G27 Road Warrior with me, MovieScouse 007, where we play Euro Truck Simulator 2 with a Logitech G27 gaming wheel and still on my crappy laptop. So, we got to Jyväskylä. I did promise that I would find out how that was pronounced between journeys, and if we quickly check out the map, this is the city we're in, and it's pronounced Jyväskylä. Jyväskylä. All right. So, in Jyväskylä, we've dropped our load. We've got two discoverables. I'm going to find the first discoverable by just turning left and left and then doing a UE when I've discovered it, because I've got a feeling that, maybe I will be able to, maybe I'll be able to do that and I get this bit of road too. So yes, the plan is to turn left, past this discoverable, and then follow the road back. And hopefully get back to here. All right, but before we do that, we're going to check out the updates that are available to us because we leveled up to level 14 at the last after the last journey, and you can see we have got bull bars, exhausts, and a paint option. It's pretty much the same for everybody. It's pretty much the same for everybody. Actually, there is a mirrors and a chassis. There's an engine. We're not buying that because it's two engines, two chassis. Wow. Renault. It's paint job. Bull bar, exhausts, metallic mirrors, chassis. You see that actually, there's more than one design. So there's two. Renault have got two designs. They've got the Magnum and they've got the Premium. So you get the paint job for both of them. You also get the chassis for both of them. Exhausts, mirrors, bull bars. So the XF Euro and the Accent XF. Oh no, sorry, XF Euro and the XF. Volvo's just got two, so you got the Classic, and then the chassis for the Classic, and the paint, and the chassis for the FH. Mercedes is only got the one, but it's got, new Actros. They've got Actros and new Actros. Okay, lovely. Man, because there's only one man, there's only one chassis, one engine. Iveco, is there more than one for the Iveco? Yeah, there is. There's the Highway and there's the Strada. So we obviously couldn't afford the Highway because it was hideously expensive. So, yeah, so that's what's available. Okay. Now, we are obviously leveling up, meant that at the moment we've still got skill points to apply. So, following our pattern, we're going to go long distance. I'm actually quite pleased about this, because I think that was what was holding us back, getting across Europe. So, skill rank 3 for long distance gives us deliveries up to 932 miles with a 15% higher reward for delivery distances longer than 621 miles. So hopefully that allows us some jobs further than Scandinavia. I think that's pretty much what was holding us back. I don't know why it wasn't allowing us to go from Copenhagen into Central Europe, because there were plenty of journeys less than that. But but before we do anything like that, let's get ourselves rested and repaired. Okay, let's shuffle myself forward so that I've got full range of clutch, parking brake off, and let's go get those discoverables. Risky. Risky. Alright, excellent. He let us through because of our aggressive, horrible driving. Alright. We've discovered a recruitment agency. Excellent. Yeah, I still don't like the fact... See, I didn't like the fact that the man engine would screech at you like it was about to die. But at least that kind of told you when to go up. That was you use engine note in real life. You use engine note to determine when to change a gear. Sorry, I'm just distracted there a little bit. You use engine note to determine when to change gear. That's how you do it. And it just wasn't giving me any. Right, so. Okay. Yep, it's not going to let me go that way. Oh, okay. Actually, I don't need to go that way. So, we have discovered that junction. My problem is my brain is running home to mother with the way that the road networks work. And that's why I assumed I had to go past. But I didn't. Because I'm driving on the right-hand side of the road, not the left-hand side of the road. So I assumed I was joining there. Yes, my brain. He's having a bit of an issue. Whoa, sugar! That's because I was looking at the map. I was too busy looking at the map, so I drove straight into the barriers. Oh my word. Right, okay, let's... go back and let's get the other discoverable and then let's rest and recuperate. We'll see what kind of dealership that is offering us. Obviously we haven't done enough journeys in this particular truck. Right, there's actual traffic on the roads now, so it behooves us to check, see what's coming. Okay, so, yes, so but we will be, hopefully we'll be adding a dealership we don't already have, which means we want to see anything but MAN, Volvo, or Iveco. Preferably, I would love to see Mercedes, because as I keep banging this drum, I want... Okay, why am I traveling so damn slowly? Because I'm in a gear that doesn't allow me to go any faster. Oh, it's a Volvo. Oh, well. Okay, before we do that... let's... So we don't want a Volvo. See, actually, take a quick look at their Volvo dealership. I can't remember the views. Here we go. Right, let's take a quick look at this Volvo. This is the new large dealership. They changed the prefab for the new dealerships, so they looked smarter and nicer, because they didn't look like a dealership. They looked like a flipping out of town warehouse or industrial unit. So they decided that really they should look a bit more like a dealership. But I think it's quite nice actually. We're not buying a Volvo, we have a Volvo. We will be buying more Volvos. We'll be moving the vehicles, the man and the Iveco out of London. And but that won't be until we've got a dealership in Munich and Iveco's, I think, Turin. So okay, damage report. We did a chunk of damage just now, which is annoying, but you know. Engine, 2% for £144. Transmission, 1% for £140. Chassis, 5% for £958. Cabin, 4% for £485. And wheels, 1% for £100. I'm pretty sure that about £1,300 of that was just now. So that's a total of £1,827. Let's do that. Let's get out of here. Let's get some rest. And then let's go find ourselves some more work. And let's hope. Yeah, it's parking. Alright, so engine off. And let's sleep. Okay. Hey, that's brought us into pretty much daylight. Right, so let's go. Not map, actually. We don't want the map. And now it's going to wait until the map appears. Right. We want the job market. Or as they say in New Zealand, market. I say this only because it did amuse me. When we were in New Zealand, they have a very unique way of pronouncing things. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just it just tickles me. So, we are in... Oh, I don't know. Jyväskylä. That's it. We're in Jyväskylä. Ooh, Debrecen. In Hungary. Finally. Here we go. Linz. In Österreich, Banská Bystrica in Slovakia, Berlin in Germany, and we have our winner. Berlin in Germany is a capital. By the time we get to Berlin, we will almost certainly have enough money to buy a garage in Berlin, which is a major capital. I want to start by buying capitals. So I think we have a winner. It's 549 miles by land, which will be enough to put us into having driven enough in this particular vehicle. There will definitely be a dealership in Berlin. We'll probably borrow some more money to buy the truck as well. This scene, I think, is going to be how we're going to play this. Let's get our journey, our lovely journey, centered on our map. I didn't like that at all. Right, so what did I do? I escaped before I accepted the job. That was idiotic. Berlin. Let's set that as our GPS destination. Right, let us go. And pick up our load. And hopefully Berlin will not be Volvo, Iveco or man. Let's hope that Berlin is Mercedes. Oops. Right, so Let's straighten up. Okay. So that's helpful. And if they're not gonna, are they gonna let us out? No, they're not gonna let us out. We're gonna be stuck here for ages. Until that light changes at the very least. So that's green, that's good. So we only have to worry about this direction. So, is anyone going to pause to let us out? Yeah, after that brown vehicle. And we're stuck at a red light again. That's fine. I don't mind. Okay. So, I went to the Great British Beer Festival at the Olympia Stadium in London yesterday, which was fantastic. It was a little bit expensive. It was £12 to get in. It was £3 for a glass. It was £2 for a program, and then every beer isn't really that cheap. The local beers were cheap. The local UK beers were cheap. Slightly. The higher percentage beer is obviously more expensive. Traditionally in the UK, our beer alcohol percentage hovers between 4% and 5%. That's where the beers fall in the UK. That's not how it works in the rest of Europe. In the rest of Europe, they tend to not stick to a sort of a band of alcohol percentages. I went on a stag do in, if you're American, a bachelor party in Brussels, in Belgium. And I know that the percentages there were quite ranged from UK low of 4% right up to wine percentages of 15%, I think, was the highest I saw. So, sorry, concentrating on that roundabout for a second. So I know that the rest of Europe doesn't. But I think one of the reasons that British beer sticks to such a narrow band is that we tend to drink alcohol very differently from the rest of Europe. The rest of Europe tends to drink alcohol while they're eating. It's a part of the meal. It's not an end in and of itself like it is in the UK. I think that's one of our biggest problems, actually. If I'm brutally honest, I think one of the biggest problems we've got is that we don't. We drink to get drunk in the UK, whereas in the rest of Europe they drink as part of the experience. That's not to say every person in continental Europe behaves that way. That's absolutely not the case. There are plenty of people that drink to get drunk in Europe. It's just that it's not the predominant experience like it is in the UK. They have bars, but they're quite small, so people tend to go there to get an aperitif or a digestive after a meal, or to meet people. It's actually quite often just to meet up. They use a bar as a meet-up point. And then they'll go to a restaurant or another event, a concert or something. They don't treat the bar as the destination itself. So let's hook up. Here we go. Right, let's attach that bad boy. And let's head to Berlin. It's a nice long journey to Berlin, which I quite like. A lot of stuttering is starting to get on my nerves. The sooner we've got this new computer, the better. My only hope is that that it's not a massive letdown. That we don't spend all this money and keep being let down by that. Oh no, we were being let out because of our poor gear discipline. We lost our slot. After this blue truck. Actually, that's not a junction that we have to indicate at. That is the road going round. We don't need the high beams. We do still need the lights because it's a bit dim. It's still 8 o'clock in the morning. Okay. Alright, we're all good. We're all good, we're good, we're good, we're good. So, yes. So it's not a means, and in the UK it's a bit of a means in and of itself. You go out to get drunk. You meet, quite often people will go to a pub, and there you won't leave the pub until they go home. That's not how I like to approach it. I don't think that's particularly. I'm not a big fan of pubs. I never have been. I used to use pubs as a means of watching my football team because I can't afford Sky, which is the broadcast, or BT Sport, which are the two broadcasters that broadcast Premier League football, which would be the only reason. Actually, Sky now have half the Formula One races, so it would be for that too. But I can't afford Sky for that, you know. That's quite a lot of money every month just for and 90 minutes a week of television. That doesn't make economic sense. Whereas the computer, it goes on. The computer that I'm about to spend £1,500 goes on as soon as we get through the door. And goes off when we go to bed, so it gets used quite a lot. The laptop that we've got at the moment gets used quite a lot, given that we'd like to get rid of the laptop. I can't see that situation changing with the new computer. In fact, I'm pretty sure that the wife will love the fact that everything works quickly on the new computer. Because it's one of her big complaints is that you click the mouse and then nothing happens for ages. Because the computer's catching up. Pretty sure she'll love the fact that the computer turns on super lightning quick as well. So we'll see. So we haven't paid a loan fee. We did pay a loan fee. We did it while we were asleep, and it was offset by our income, which is the hope. The hope is that the other four drivers start pitching in. I know the newest driver won't, but certainly the two original drivers that I got when I got my first loan to buy the Volvo. If you remember, I bought a Volvo. I bought the garage with the three slots. I bought the Volvo and I bought two other trucks and recruited two drivers to drive. So look at this nice. We're getting a click on. We're getting a bit of a wriggle on, which is good. I still don't like the expanded polystyrene dashboard. I don't like how difficult it is to how awkward it is to check both the speedo and the rev counter. That's one of the things I love most about the Volvo, is that the rev counter and the speedo are in the same place, so you just have to look down once. I love that. So yes, so basically the Olympia Stadium is a large indoor arena. They have all sorts of events there. They have the BBC food festival there. They have beer and wine festivals there. That was some really bad driving there by someone not concentrating and overbraking, because he didn't need to brake that much. I will get better at those roundabouts. I'm still not brilliant at those roundabouts. Someone released a mod that allowed you to move the navigation GPS to an iPad. Oh, I would love that. I'd love to know how that works. I'm not sure how that works. I have a horrible feeling that the guy had to destroy the iPad. He had to wire the computer into the iPad, which I'm not prepared to do at the moment. I will do. When I upgrade my iPad for a newer iPad, I would be prepared to do it. I just don't think I have the technical know-how to do it. But it would be good to be able to use the iPad as a GPS, so that you've got a much better, clearer, more realistic view. The only issue then would be that you guys wouldn't... Actually, in this lorry, you wouldn't see it, but in the Volvo, the GPS is on the dashboard. I've got some orange juice to wet my whistle, but I've got a feeling it's drying my mouth out. I don't think it's having the desired effect. I wish I had a pint of water. I think lesson learned. I'll have a pint of water for the next journey. So, as of this point, I know my last video was video number 8, and that was quite some time ago. I think that was January, and we're now in August. So 8 months. I'm 8 months late delivering videos. I'm going to try, as I said in the previous video, I'm trying out some editing options. Obviously, the Adobe Premiere one is a demo. So the video that I'm doing on Adobe Premiere can't be used because it has demo all over it, all over the screen, which I can't put on YouTube, because that would just look stupid. So as soon as I think I've discounted Lightning. I can't get it to work. Its menu system is a bit counterintuitive, whereas Adobe Premiere Elements is more sophisticated, than Windows Movie Maker, but it's a similar interface. It allows you to do the side-by-side video editing, so that if you're editing one scene into another, you can see, you can sort of like tick forward and backwards to, so that you can exactly splice it right. Because I know when I'm doing some of, when I was doing my Spec Ops The Line videos, I think one of the big problems is where I'm trying to merge together a good version of each scene, and I die a lot in that game. I'm not gonna pretend that I'm super awesome at that game. I die a lot when I'm playing that game. So what that means is that I've got to edit together. Ooh, I'm going a bit fast, especially as I've got to come off in a second. Let's not go that side. Let's go this side. Right, okay, so we're coming off here, so let's really slow down, because we're doing a... Um, And so it's very difficult on Movie Maker to splice those videos together because you can't see the out shot and the in shot to sort of get the positioning right so that the viewer's got the smoothest possible experience. I'm looking forward to that. There's also Blackmagic's bit of software, and that one's a freebie. The thing I like, Elements isn't not free, it's £48, I think. But it allows you unlimited video and audio tracks, which was a thing that was halting me. I've been kind of waiting for a better piece of software so that I can do FIFA, because FIFA comes with a stereo track for the audio, for the in-game audio, which means I can't put a music track on top of it for my intros. Oh, sugar, nearly missed that. So I've been kind of hanging on to two full seasons worth of FIFA because I can't put them together, I can't get the music on them. And it kind of requires music. They really need music. So I just need to see whether Blackmagic allows multiple audio and video tracks. We'll see. But that's going to happen in September, because in September we've got a house guest. Oh no. Please don't crash. Okay, what the hell was that? If you're concerned, that wasn't YouTube. The game just froze for 5 or 6 seconds. I've got a horrible feeling that flipping Kaspersky's doing something in the background, or Apple are trying to get me to download an update to iTunes. Both of those things caused my computer to have a fit, because it can't do either of those things and anything else. I remember when I was in New Zealand, quite often I would be able to record one of these games and I would be able to have YouTube in the background processing a previous video. So it can do that, but yeah. Not Kaspersky, not Norton, not you, Apple. Yes, what was I talking about? My brain has just melted into my ears. This is very annoying. So this time, instead of going to Sweden, we are going to Sweden. Maybe we're taking the boat from Sweden, I don't know. Oh, I just paid a loan installment. 9,000. Okay. 9,000. So we actually earned some extra money that I didn't see. Because we were on 104 the last time, so we must have been on 109. Because we're down to 100. So this is all good. Oh, are we alright for fuel? Yeah, we're alright for fuel. Got a lovely big tank. Let's slow down because I can't see anything ahead of that giant Scania. Alright, he's gonna let me. Of course, I've lost all my flipping momentum because I had to take my foot off the accelerator. of the gas, as the Americans would say. But we will get him. We'll get him before the next junction, hopefully. We're crossing the next junction, that's fine. Turku. Let's slow down. Slow down, because I've got a feeling that this is our... This might be our... Actually, we didn't have to brake that hard. We were doing 50 for the speed camera. So, are we taking a boat from here? That's the question. I do not know. But it is a good question. Doing the speed limit, that's good. And then we're going to be taking a left here. Hello. Okay. Interesting. Stuff's just disappearing around me. I got a feeling this is because my computer's not capable of dealing with as much detail as it's being asked to. Drop down, I guess, we get some more traction. Alright, yeah, I think we're going to the... don't know where we're going. So I've completely lost the plot with this video, I do apologise. So, bag of neutrals. That's why it sounded funny. That's why we're not going very fast. Let's get into 9 and get some speed up. Right. Okay, we're coming off here. Yes, we do. I'm going a little bit fast. I thought I was familiar with the port. This doesn't look familiar. No, it is. It is. It's the port. I don't know what's the matter with my brain. So, are we going to Sweden or are we going to Germany? Yes. My feeling is that we're going to Germany. But one can never be 100% certain. Slow down just a bit. So we don't destroy the load. And then we'll get on the boat. We'll get some rest because our lad looks a bit knackered. You can see the bed is filling with blue. And on to our boat. To the left. And then hopefully. Okay. Yeah. We're going to Sweden. I'm Okay, so we're going to drive through Sweden, we're going to drive through Denmark, and then we're going to drive into Germany. £640, my favorite noise. Okay, it's not my favorite noise, but it does tickle me. And I have no idea why. Now, I have a feeling, actually, maybe we're not. Maybe we're going to get onto another ferry. Maybe we're going to get onto another ferry. So that's Stockholm. Jyväskylä to Berlin. £30,000, near as damn it. That's an 11-hour journey. So hopefully we'll have made some, our lads and lasses will have made some loot for us while we've been on the boat, so that we only have to take a loan for the truck and not for the garage. Yes, yeah, something's going on in the background because it's no, they've made no loot for us whatsoever. So let's quickly look at our map. Let's see where we're going from here, where the GPS is taking us from here. God, everything is incredibly slow. Yeah, we're going through Sweden, through Copenhagen. Are you kidding me? Through the UK? No, no, that can't be right. That can't be right. Ah, no. We need to take another boat to Gdansk. Yes. No, that's what we need to do. We need to take another boat to Gdansk. So, let's enter. Yes. I was going to say. I'm just, you know, those yellow lines were just where I've been. I'm really not on the ball today. So let's go from to Gdansk. 19 hours, £425. Oh, I could have gone through Stockholm, driven down, but that would have been really silly. And it would have probably made us late with our delivery, which is never good. You never want to be late with your delivery. Yeah, oh my word, this is, everything's taking so much longer. Jyväskylä. Jyväskylä. I'm sorry, Jyväskylä. 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 To Berlin. So yes. Yes, the Olympia Stadium is in fact an indoor arena. So, ooh, you discovered Gdansk. £3,000 in 19 hours. Oh my god. No. We are not going to make the money. We're not going to make the money for the garage without a loan. Oh my god. No, no, we are not. Unless one of our drivers is doing a really long distance journey. Oh. Right. I'm sorry, I have to pause for a second and find out whatever it is that's causing my computer to slow down. Bear with me a second. Okay, I couldn't find anything, which is bizarre. It's not running anything, so my computer's just running out of puff, which is worrying. So I just hope that it doesn't happen too often. This is not very pretty. Okay, I got a horrible feeling this is just going to be the experience for the rest of this video. Is that we're going to be stuttering, which is deeply disappointing, not just for me but for you guys too. It can't be much fun to watch a video that's constantly stuttering. Unless, of course, it makes you feel better about your equipment. At least mine doesn't do that kind of thing. Alright. I got a feeling we're actually going to discover a discoverable in Gdansk. I'm half tempted to sort of do the other one while we're here, because it's only a minor detour. Yeah, it's a recruitment agency. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do a Yui. I'm going to do it. Okay, ignore the GPS. And a Scania. I think we have a Scania depot. Which we've already got. God. Okay. And we got away with that. We got away with blatting through a red light. So we will we'll get back on track. So it's going to take us 8 hours and 49 minutes of in-game time. We've got 47 hours to do it. We don't have to sleep for 10 hours, so we're fine. This is not going to bugger. You get away with one and it nails you on another. Oh. So we're definitely at the end of this journey be ready to change trucks. We have bought 5 trucks. My feeling is that will allow us to buy trucks online, which means that we can buy the Scania online. Hopefully. So, unless Berlin has a Mercedes dealership, which I'm kind of hoping it does, then then we'll be moving to Scania. Not because I prefer the Mercedes to the Scania. I haven't driven the new Actros, but I don't think we'll be able to afford the new Actros. But I just I think in general I prefer the Scania to the Mercedes, just because of the dashboard. I'm not fond of the dashboard. So pretty much every bit of road we're now driving on is new to us, which is excellent. I don't mind going to Scandinavia, I really don't, and it was new for the DLC, which is fine. But we kind of ended up living it, and we were going to the same places as well. It's not so bad if you're going to different places. But we were going up the same roads all the time. which is not, you know, it's not what you want to explore. That's what we're playing this game for. Explore Europe in a truck, deliver loads, have a laugh, have a chat. And yeah, so when I think we're now well on our way, I'm not sure that it's a straight run from here, but it's, I don't think we'll have too many deviations. He says deviating from the lane, he should be in. Actually, I will get in the outside lane, because like I said, I think we are straight on from here. I don't know, we'll be trapped on the inside lane and then having to slow down or stop for traffic that's already in the lane we want to be in. And cars can undertake us if they want to. That's allowed in Central Europe. It's illegal in the United Kingdom. You are not allowed to undertake in the United Kingdom. You're also not allowed to do what I'm doing, which is living in the outside lane in the United Kingdom. The lane nearest to the slip roads, or on ramps as they're called in America, that's the road you should be in. The other two roads are overtaking lanes. The other two lanes are overtaking lanes. It's one of the things I do like about the basic trucks is that they don't go. Let's slow down, because I think there are speed cameras at the. Oh no, I can't go through that one. But I can go through this one. This is old school. I do think, yeah. I do like having a mix of the two different styles. I was a bit worried that all of the toll booths in it were now going to be just tags. With a drive-through element, which is fine as a sort of a novelty, but it's not. You want to have something different each time. Okay. Yes, when I came home from the beer festival, I wasn't in the mood for cooking anything. And I didn't get home until 11:30. Well, I said I didn't get near home until 11:30. So I decided to stop and have a poisonous, dirty burger from a famous, well-known burger franchise that has a Scottish sound to its name. Let's go get some petrol. Let's go get some fuel. We are getting low, and I would hate to run out. So, engine off. Let's get the fuel. We're not going to have a rest here because we don't need it. It's quite a lot of fuel. So, yes, I am feeling somewhat guilty about my culinary decision, or lack thereof. So I'm going to have a healthy lunch today, as a recompense for my poisonous alcohol-soaking meal. So I don't know whether whether that plan was a good that alcohol plan was a good idea, but alcohol recovery plan was a good idea, but it's what I did. I mean, I went to a large festival whose sole purpose was to sell you beer. They had all sorts of beer from all over the United Kingdom and from all over the world. They had beer from every county, every city, They had beer from most of the major Europe. I was in neutral again. That's why I was drifting to halt. I'm wearing a... Ooh, crikey, I'm drifting all over. I'm wearing a top that keeps pulling up and my back keeps hitting the sticky chair that I'm sat on. That's not good. We're coming off here, so it wasn't a straight shot after all. That's one of these lovely narrow. Slow and steady is the plan. And then left. Tozzles, it's. Right, we're gonna pull. We're in the road. That's not good. Right, that's just as well as nothing coming. My gear changing is not getting any better. You can still hear them. If you can't find it, grind it. Alright, it's toll booth time. Let's go here. Let's enter that. £37. My foot came off the clutch far too quickly. So I'm now starting to recognise roads from old gameplays. Pretty sure I've been this way many times. So we're still in Poland, and we're heading for Germany. Gear discipline has got a lot better. No grinding there at all. Excuse me. So we're going to have to drive through Poland to get into Germany, but Berlin is near the top of Germany. It's sort of northeast. In it, I believe. I might now discover when we look at the map at the end of the journey, the beginning of the next journey, sorry, that I'm nowhere near correct. That it's nowhere near the northeast. But I think it's northeast. In my mind, it's the northeast quarter of Germany. Excuse me. Huge frog in my throat. I had a cold in May, and I have not been able to get rid of the excess phlegm. It just keeps making a reappearance. So I don't feel like I'm getting better, even though I am. Do you know what? Every time this game stops stuttering, I get complacent, and then it stutters, and I think, oh no. I'm going to put the high beams on because it's that time of day, 10 o'clock in the evening, and we're on these long country roads and I just want to see the road ahead. So yes, you buy a glass for this beer festival and it comes with three markers. It comes with a third of a pint marker, a half a pint marker and a full pint marker. The idea is that you sort of wander around for most of the day having a third of a pint, sampling all the different kinds of beers, and then towards the end of the day you pick your favourite and then you go and have a pint of that. And that was my plan, but I was late getting to the festival because I had to wait in for a courier, and as such I was about 3 hours behind my friends, And so, although I started while I was looking for them, I bought a third of a pint just so I had something to drink while I was looking for them. And then when I found them, we just started on the pints. So I restrained myself a little bit in that I only had five and a third pints. Sadly, the beer I liked the most is the one that I started with, which is the one I had a third of a pint of, which is a shame, but that's how it goes. That's how it goes. I did enjoy, thoroughly enjoyed it, sampling beers from all over the United Kingdom, beers, local beers, craft beers that I wouldn't normally get to drink because they normally don't make it anywhere near London. Normally they're sort of, they sell them locally because that's, they make a certain amount and they can only afford to send it a certain distance. Nonetheless, it was lovely, and I think this is going to be a tradition for me. I think I am going to start doing the beer festival every year because it was good fun. I did thoroughly enjoy it. Okay, that was way too sharp a corner for me to be doing that speed. And I haven't heard a dicky bird out of my drivers for quite some time. So my gear discipline is, it's not my gear discipline, it's my clutch discipline. It's continually letting me down. I'm kind of trying to drive this like I would a sports car. So I'm dipping the clutch and slamming the gear in as quickly as possible, which is almost certainly not the best approach. So yes, you get a special glass. I say special glass. It's not that special. I mean, it's a normal beer glass, and it's got the distinctive markings for third of pint, half a pint, and a full pint. But it also has a little logo on it, and it depends on who sponsored the event, what the general mood is, and what the designer of the logo has decided. This year, I think that Hobgoblin sponsored the beer festival, and so it was a Hobgoblin-esque logo on the beer thing, and it said the Great British Beer Festival 2015, which was good fun. I'm driving all over this road. I'm using every bit of this road because I'm trying to hit apexes. But I am going to hit cars if I'm not careful. Oh, we've got a bus in front of us, I think. And there you go. Okay. I'm going to have to slow down. Because I don't know. Can we overtake him without crashing? Yes, we did. We overtook him without crashing. We are approaching a junction though, so. Wow, we really overtook him. He's disappeared into the distance. I mean, by that I mean not like the computer's just vanished him. I mean, like his silhouette was significantly smaller. Right, let's just double check we're not. Nothing coming? Nothing coming? Let's go. Actually, we didn't need to check that way. We needed to check left. He caught us up with our junction shenanigans. See, that bus is still behind us, but he's going to disappear once we oh god, my gear, my clutch controls just sucks. Yes, they do have seating areas at this beer festival. If in general, because you're wandering around having a third of a pint, you're sort of moving from brewer to brewer. There's not really a great deal of time to sit down because you're kind of moving. That's not the way we played it. We spent a lot of time chatting, actually, which is probably not the way to do it. But there's nothing quite like a lovely craft beer. It is good. This is a nice steep hill. Let's just drop a gear just to mind you, we do have another junction, another change of direction coming. Oh, come on. Get over. I'm going. I think we're going over a road. No? Was it a river? Maybe it's a river. This time we do, because we're crossing one lane to get to the other lane, we do have to look in both directions. And nothing coming, so let's go. Oversteering. That's not clever. Wow. Yeah, a lot better movement on the truck. They also had the occasional bit of food. They had a bunch of food stands, just, you know, because if you're drinking all day, you want something to eat. You should be eating. So yeah, we did enjoy some sausage rolls. But there was other things. There were kebabs, and there were burgers, and there were other kinds of meaty pies and pastries and stuff. Not savoury pastries. And if we're taken by a little yellow car, bless it. Which is always good. Well, like I said, we had sausage rolls, which were nice. Not too fatty. Considerably more meat than I'm used to having in a sausage roll. Sausage rolls you normally get from the shops tend to come with an awful lot of pastry. It's not actually a lot of pastry. Basically, the flakes are separated. It's flaky pastry, and the flakes are separated, so it looks bulkier than it is. You crush into it, and you get a skinny sausage-like lump of meat. This was quite substantial. Some directions here. This must be to escape Poland and journey into Deutschland. From Polska to Deutschland. I don't know what the anthem for Poland is, but I do know what the anthem for Germany is. Although you don't sing the verses that everyone assumes you sing, that's not how the German national anthem goes anymore. So, we are discovering new roads with every inch that we drive. Because you'll see, we're going to light up this junction in this. There we go, it's just lit up. One of the things we are going to do when we get very wealthy is to try go back to Britain as possible. I want There's an achievement for having all of the garages in the country that's your home base. Now, foolishly, I've got Britain as my home base. I'm British, I felt, you know. But that means that I've got about 30 cities to buy a garage in. So, you know, ever the masochist, I think I might try and do that in this profile. With the United Kingdom. Okay. Let's pay our bill and go. Was that free? Charged, I didn't hear the ch-ch-ching. Bizarre. I wonder if something's gone wrong with our GPS, that we're not getting notifications of income and outgoings. Because we should have been charged, but no, we got charged for the petrol. When we stopped for petrol, we got charged, and it let us know. So maybe there's a fault with that. That's too steep a hill for 11th. Let's keep it in 9th. Yes. So, to go back to the video editing, I'm chopping all over this video from subject to subject. To go back to the video editing thing for a minute. I'm out bag of neutrals again. That keeps happening. Concentrate. The plan is to edit these things as quickly as possible, because what I plan to do is to do one of these a week whenever I can, but to catch up so they're not too far behind. I don't have a massive, because I have a massive black backlog of editing to do. So what I might have to do is cease gaming for a little while and concentrate on editing. But it does require me, I've lost complete confidence in Movie Maker. It doesn't work for me. It's not helping me, but I need to have confidence in the other software, that it's not just able to do the editing but also to do the processing, so that I get a good video at the end of it. And I won't know that until I've done one of these things. Ooh, that's no, we haven't got it. Oh no, it's got it. Because it's so close to the road, it just counts it as having done. It just doesn't do it with those big ones. We are going to have to go back to Sweden to get that. And I'm in no doubt whatsoever that I will be dragged back to Sweden at some point. So if we go to Stockholm, if we get a journey to Stockholm, I might go to Stockholm and buy the garage in Stockholm. But yes, I've just no confidence in Movie Maker. It won't let you do anything. It's clumsy controls. There's no fine control over anything. No fine control over fade in or fade out. It's got a few effects, but they're pretty basic, and you can tell when a video's been made on Movie Maker. Because you can recognize the transitions, the speed at which stuff goes in and out. So it's time to move on to something a bit more professional. I'm not professional enough for Premiere Pro, but Premiere Elements looks like it might be the thing for me. So we'll see. But that's the plan anyway. So 2 hours of this journey left. I'm starting to get a little bit of a hoarse throat, so I'm planning to do another video straight away, but I think I might get some water and maybe have a snack between videos. But I'm trying to knock quite a few of these out so that I can so that I can build up a backlog, and I've got some stuff to work with. And also, I'm going to try and catch up. So the idea is, once I've decided which piece of editing software I'm going to use, I'm going to knock video after video out, so that so what you will find is probably one day after the other. Okay, so that was a freebie. I just paid 42 quid for that one. That's a relief. The game isn't broken. So what you might find is that for about maybe a week or 2 weeks, you're getting a video every single day. Obviously, by the time you've watched this video, those videos will have appeared, so it won't be a surprise to you. You'll have seen it happen. But it will be a surprise to me because I haven't done it yet. If that makes any sense to you. Alright, we are leaving Poland and entering Germany. This isn't where we would stop for a customs inspection. Surprised they don't do that. I mean, I know it's annoying and it gets in the way of the journey, but it would be like this added little extra bit of realism that you have to stop for a customer's inspection. Not there, mind you, we're not really smuggling anything. That's not what this game is about, so maybe it wouldn't be a good idea, actually, now that I think about it. So I don't think that we will make it to level 15 in this game, but I think that we will have made enough of a dent in level 14 that level 15 should be achievable by the next journey. There's another petrol station. I love seeing the little bits of gold road appear when you pass junctions and petrol stations, the sort of the ones that are nearby the road. It tells me that I'm actually discovering bits of road, which is good. I like it. I'm doing drifting. I think we're at 56 miles an hour, which is probably the as fast as it goes. So the engine just freewheels when it's at maximum, because it's got a limiter on. For the sake of realism, I'm not prepared to take the limiter off, mind you, and also for the sake of the load, because I've seen what happens to where the limiter is removed. If you ever want to see what happens to a vehicle when you take the limiter off, then there's a Twitch user who I think also has a YouTube channel called Killer Quack, and he's a Scania man, and he drives as fast as is humanly possible, and he spends almost all of his income repairing his truck, and he loses quite a lot of income in fines for delivering a broken load, because he crashes all the time. Oh, which that junction just went gold. I love it. And we're going to drop a gear. And we're going to drop another gear, so that we can put our foot down at this junction. No, I'm not used to the way that this Iveco works, and I'm not keen on it, and no one can say that I haven't given this a good go. I've driven 1,000 miles, at least 1,000 miles in this thing, and I just don't like it. I don't like that the bit of the dashboard that's the most useless is the bit of the dashboard that's the brightest. I don't like the fact that during the daylight it looks like expanded polystyrene. Again with the neutral instead of being in 11th. Ugh. Right, I need to get over because we're going to be turning off towards Berlin and Leipzig and Magdeburg. Those hay bales remind me that I have Farming Simulator 2015 on my PS4, and actually I've videoed the training missions for those. So what I'll do is I will put the training missions up, because I'm not sure there's much point in the game, in filming the game itself. I could have filmed finding the gold coins, but I found 10 of them before I thought to do it, so that's not happening. There are 100 gold coins dropped around the map, and when you find the first 10, the other 90 appear as little golden dots on the map, so that's fun. Oh, we're so close. We're 13 minutes away from our depot. That snuck up on me. Okay. Damn it. I can't see the... There we go. This is why I want the track IR, so that I can do that. With my head, though. Not with my fingers. That should be otherwise occupied. So are we heading into Berlin itself? It does look like we're kind of heading into Berlin itself. Yeah, it looks like it. We have 38 hours left, and oh, we've discovered Berlin. So if there's, I might find the discoverables, you know. See what dealership we've got. See whether we're looking at a Mercedes dealership, or not. It looks like I can do a UE if I want to. Is it a dealership or is it a recruitment agency that's just there? That's a recruitment agency. Alright. I want to see... Yeah, recruitment agency. That's, I mean, it's good, because it means more drivers. But, yes, given that we've got 38 hours, I'm going to go and find that discoverable and then come back. I'm going to go and find that dealership. And then just hope that it's Mercedes. Too aggressive and urgent with the braking. Alright, come on, change. Let's show us the Mercedes. Right. That's what we want to see. We want to see Mercedes. No, it's man. Darn it. Oh well. So, we will be buying a Scania and a dealership at the beginning. And we can't go. Because we now have a red light. Alright. So, now is the time for us to demonstrate our appalling parking skills. So we're going to work our way back to the... tired. Are you tired? You've got an hour and a half, sunshine. Suck it up. It's my mean way of saying that you're not getting a rest just yet, young fella, my lad. Okay, let's hope that right, he's determined for me to go back that way. And I've got a feeling that's because... No, we're good. Because this particular road is raised. We drove under it to get to the man dealership. It up this up ahead on the left. So nothing's coming in the opposite direction. We're good to go. And then that's on the left here. And again, nothing coming. See that ball at the top of the screen? It's just disappearing out of the screen. If I pop it smack in the middle of the screen, that's a famous Berlin Mantel landmark. In fact, and now that, of course, I go back to that view, it all becomes clear. It's this one we have to go round. This is one of the old traditional ones where we have to go round. And then through, I think, a narrow underpass. And then that's where we've got to put it. Pass through. And then. Right, so. I want to slightly steer that way and then steer gently back. Or maybe not so gently. That's not worked. And I'm screwing the pooch on this one, I tell you. This is going to be fun. Not. So. Don't oversteer in that direction. Hopefully that should be it. Nope, that's not it, but we are getting closer. This is, I've been quite lucky in my last few journeys because I've either had a really easy parking or I've fluked it. There we go, we're in. Now, hopefully, this is back to the excellence. Let's put the parking brake on. That's engine off. And let's unhook the load. Did we get an excellent? Yes! We got an excellent. Ooh, we got ourselves a nice chunk of XP. Oh, so close to level 15. So, from we got an excellent for delivering neon from Jyväskylä. Oh gosh, I've forgotten how to pronounce it already. We've got an excellent for delivering a load from Jyväskylä. There we go. Sorry about the bang. I put my iPad to my thing so you could hear it. Jyväskylä. So we delivered neon from Jyväskylä to Berlin. We drove 562 miles. We took 44 hours and 54 minutes. We consumed 383.2 litres of fuel, which gave us a base reward of £20,374 and 906 XP. We got a proficiency bonus for level 14 of £4,278. An ADR delivery bonus of 190 XP, a long distance delivery bonus for skill rank 3 of £1,882 and 226 XP. We got a fragile cargo bonus for skill rank 2 of £1,882 and 199 XP, an urgent delivery bonus for skill rank 2 of £1,130 and 181 XP, and our 45 XP bonus for parking the trailer. This gives us a total of £29,546 and 1,747 XP. So, this profile has a lifetime experience of 24,482 XP, and we are still aiming at 24,600 XP. Oh my word. That's a ridiculous, 118 XP. That is so easily achievable in the next journey. So, it was wonderful to get back on the excellent horse. It was wonderful to get back into Central Europe. Not that I wasn't enjoying Scandinavia. I just feared that we'd never leave Scandinavia. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video and you haven't already done so, please click like. If you like these videos and think you'd like to watch more, then please subscribe. If you know someone who you think might like these videos, point them in this direction. And until I see you in the next video, I'll see you on the road.